Good, thank you. Today, we are grateful having time with the scribes, the journalists, those who are doing great job to the society by taking the message of people to people so that people can understand what is their future. So today, INPT as such had held its central working committee to formulate and to decide the decisions of member central committee held on 15th of November here at Press Club. So we have decided on 5th of December, INPT going to launch 12-hour national highway road blockade at Sadhu Chandrapara, Champang Nagar, just foothill of Baramura, including railway. So railway belongs to central government, road, national highway belongs to state government, and being used by the whole people of India. So just to expose our desire and our unhappiness, we are going to launch this 12-hour road blockade. So main demand is to drop the citizenship amendment bill from the business list of parliament. We have seen in the YouTube website of parliament, it is clearly mentioned about citizenship amendment bill. It should be not 16, but it should be now 19, because the last 16 is dropped already, and now they will have to have new list mentioning 19. So we are strongly opposing it, including all the northeastern state, all groups like students and businessmen, and all the civil society of the Northeast. So we join our voice and action with the rest of the Northeast states. And students had already organized 4-hour sit and strike on 15th of this month at Kumlung. And in Shillong they launched, in Guwahati also they launched. Now if this is not honor, then we will be bound to meet and discuss with all the intellectual group of the Northeast. So there will be greater movement, and it will be difficult for the government to control it also. So now, just to inform the central government that we are unhappy with the proceeding of the parliament, because the central government, BJP-led government, is trying to use the power against our indigenous people of the Northeast. So we are very much against it, and we hope, and we will be inviting all other regional parties, indigenous based regional parties to help us, to join us. We will approach to them, we will appeal to them also. So this is number one, our demand. Beside many other demands, one more demand is very crucial about Brew community displaced. They are, I think, in 6 camps in this Kanchanpur subdivision. So many of them might have returned to Mizoram, but they are very unhappy. They are feeling that they are not put in their own way. They are not getting back their own land also. So many of them came back to the base where they were put in refugees camp. But we cannot term them as refugees. They are today displaced people. And so INPT have decided to demand the central government and the state government to continue their ration and other amenities required for living till the time comes for their settlement. Now, from INPT, we are demanding central government should consider if many of them may be willing to settle in Tripura. Tripura is not foreign country, Mizoram also is not foreign country. So if Bangladesh people can come settle in Agartala and in Tripura, in Mizoram, in entire northeast, why Mizoram displaced people cannot come back to Tripura? So they are also have given their desire if Tripura government can consider and give them rehabilitation settlement in Tripura also. This is one of the new item and demand INPT has taken. So we will appeal the central government to review its stand, because they have numbers of dialogue with the BRU displaced people leaders and Mizoram state government and Tripura state government. So they are failing. They are already more than 22 years. They have not come foreign from outside India. They are from within India. So why government should not reconsider their views and settle them also here in Tripura, if they are happier than Mizoram? Because Mizoram, they are not feeling happy. So if they are happy to be settled in Mizoram, they should be settled here. This is INPT's stand now. So many other, I think, decision we have already expressed to the press people, and you want to know about which point, I do not know. And we have mentioned in our Charter of Demand regarding restoration of land of tribals. Why state government is not restoring, which had already been finalized and given verdict by the magistrate. They are not returning land of tribals. This is another point. And one more point, very serious, is that regarding forest dweller, a group of forest cadre, retired forest cadre, had approached the Supreme Court single bench, and they succeeded to bring a verdict that those who are dwelling in reserve forest areas should be drive away. They should be uprooted, they should be chased out like an animal. So we say that even our traditional dweller, the indigenous people from time immemorial, we are settling in the hills, in forest. And the government of India came only last 40, 50 or 60, 70 years only. We are in the hills for thousands and thousands of years. If they decide to uproot the settler in RF, then there will be problem. They're going to create new problem. So we are appealing to the government not to take this kind of action. And another point regarding traditional dwellers, they are not giving 25 kanis, which is prescribed in the Act of this 2006 about the
Forest Right Act.
This, what do they call it in Bengali? Forest area dwellers, no? Traditional dwellers. So we say that all the dwellers should be given 25 kanis of land. Otherwise they allot only one ganda, two ganda, and that's also they don't have area. They don't have demarcation, boundary also. So we say that why you are doing like that? We are people, we're not animal. So you give us according to the Act 25 kanis, so that in that 25 kanis we can raise rubber, we can raise bamboos, any other species of the forest product, there is no problem. But why they should give us less than that area? So it is also our demand that they should allot 25 kanis, and many, many families are waiting. They are not doing it. So it is also exposing that they are not happy with giving land to indigenous people. Why they should expose their communalism? They are exactly doing like a communal. When tribal are supposed to get some right, they will do hanky-panky, they are not going to do sincerely. They should not do like that. They should not feel that we are not realizing. We know everything. So I think any state government, including Congress, CPM, BJP, they must know that we know everything, their mindset. They should love the people of the state first. We don't say that we're communal. But when I demand my right, I become communal. It is too bad, very unfortunate. Now, one more demand we have is that our employment problem, now almost over the past 25 to 27 years, they are not organizing any special recruitment drive. Backlog is almost 30,000 now. And if government has to recruit employees, they must recruit from the tribal only now. Because here and there, they are putting their own men without proper recruitment. Now, that's why many are retiring, many have left. So, in the place of five staff in some office, there are only one and two. So, they are not able to perform their responsibility. So, people in general are victimized now. Many offices, they are not working. And if I go for some job, some work, to do some official papers, I'm not getting it. They said the staff has not come. So why it should be? So we feel that that special recruitment drive should be created, and they should recruit from open market according to their qualification. This is our demand. Thank you. The rest, if you have in Bengali, our General Secretary will deliberate.